and welcome to another Top 10 brought to you by Out of HP. I'm Victoria, the Master Chief.
And I'm David, the Magician.
Today, we'll be talking about some things that are pretty terrible.
Okay, so we understand that marketing is really hard.
You know, you have to make the game, which is pretty tough, and then you have to market on top of it, which could be even tougher.
Okay, so there are some good marketing campaigns, and then there are the ones on this list.
And with that, we bring you the top 10 most terrible marketing ideas of all time.
We're not only looking for ridiculous, we're looking for unsuccessful. So Tori, you're ridiculous and unsuccessful. You should start.
That's mean, man.
I hate you. Please die.
And we're dead. The Daikatana ad. Now, Daikatana is known and pretty notorious for multiple reasons, but let's take a step back and reminisce about that terrible ad campaign. John Romero is gonna make you his bitch. I guess it's supposed to illustrate how badass the game is gonna be, but the game just ended up being terrible.
Number 9, Homefront Red Balloons. The problem was the plan was to release a lot of red balloons, 10,000 red balloons in San Francisco. As you'd imagine, it didn't come out very well. It was a huge environmental hazard and people were not happy. Sure, Crytek released a statement saying that they're 100% biodegradable, but it really doesn't help. I mean, 10,000? What were they thinking? Just do 99.
Number 8, Duke Nukem Forever. I mean, Duke Nukem is totally not controversial. It's probably the most egalitarian game we've seen in this century. The developer was like, let's do an event in a bar and make it into a strip club. Classy. And two, let's put up all these ads everywhere. What does the censorship even mean in this context? It makes no sense. The gun's not gonna what itself. And on top of it, it was marketed in generally poor areas, which assumes that poor people are gonna understand the vulgarity of this ad. I don't think anybody got it.
Number 7. Your mom hates Dead Space 2.
Your mom hates Dead Space 2.
You know, my mom thought it controlled very well and is very atmospheric, okay? See, the idea was that it was supposed to be like a focus group, so they brought in, as they put it, a bunch of middle-aged moms from Middle America and showed them the most horrifying scenes from the game. As you'd imagine, they didn't take it so well. The idea was that if your mom hates Dead Space 2, you'll obviously love it because you love everything your mom hates. Maybe you'll love me.
Nobody loves you.
My mom, no, she doesn't. Shit.
Number 6. 666. Dante's Inferno. Now, I get it. This is a game about hell, and it's going to be a controversial game, but the way they went about marketing the game was pretty terrible. You were supposed to go around and take pictures with the hottest booth babes you could see. Great, so let's objectify women, because women don't get enough of that already. And if you got the best picture, then you gotta take that woman and a group of hot women with you to Nevada, Las Vegas, Sin City. Get it? And on top of it, they organized fake religious protests in protest of the game, in which the Catholic Church responded to those fake protests. I guess they got what they wanted.
Number 5, PSP ads. Now, we were actually gonna do two separate categories, but both these fails had to be put together. Okay, first one. Remember those stupid squirrels? Really interesting cartoon characters talk in what's supposed to be like an accent.
Please, you have about as much skills as a chipmunk.
Yo, mama's a chipmunk.
Oh no, he got denied just like you get denied by the lady.
And even if you didn't think it was racist or any of that, it was just annoying. It didn't make you want to buy a PSP. Okay, that's one fail. How about the next one? Well, a year later, they decided to release the PSP White. Someone had the bright idea. Picture some guy busting into a marketing meeting saying, guys, I got it. Okay, we're gonna have a white model hold the neck of a black model. That's perfect. I mean, they're women. It's not racist, right? I mean, that's okay. Right?
Number 4, God of War 2. They asked their dinner guests to come. Look at this biblical goat on the table. Get it? Scapegoating? And please, pull out your dinner from this dead goat. Animal rights activists had a heyday with this, so PlayStation immediately sent out an apology saying, sorry, we didn't, you know, it was a mistake, we don't understand, yeah, good job PlayStation.
Number 3, Resident Evil 5 Zombie Contest. Okay, so, for the UK release of Resident Evil 5, Someone thought it'd be a good idea to have a contest that you could win a trip to Africa. All you had to do was collect disembodied body parts covered in fake blood with real chicken livers. That can't go wrong, right? Even if you got it right, you would have people collecting body parts, going into the middle of a park or somewhere screaming, and that was what was supposed to happen in that stupid. What ended up happening is people were scared because for whatever reason these body parts were stolen from the office or something, and they were just scattered around. So Capcom had to issue a statement saying, don't be alarmed, they're fake. Sure, the blood is real, or at least the liver is, but the body parts are fake, so just return them to us and we'll call it even. Not a good idea.
Okay, number two, Shadow Man 2 Gravestone. Now, hear me out without trying to laugh, because this was their brilliant marketing idea. They said, hey, we will pay for your funeral if you only allow us to put the name of our game on your beloved's headstone. It's pretty ridiculous. It's pretty disgusting. They thought, hey, we could take advantage of poor people. I don't really know if anybody took them up on the offer, but if they're still looking, I'm ready to kill David.
Before we get to number one, I think it's time for some honorable mentions. I'll go first. So for mine, it's for Burnout 2. Their bright idea was to, well, on a specific day, pay for any and all speeding tickets you get. So you bring them the speeding ticket and they'll pay it for you. The only reason it's an honorable mention is because no one actually did it. Like, it was shut down before it started because it was a stupid idea. Your turn.
My honorable mention is Hold Your Wii for Wii. Now this one ended in death. Not funny, it did. So the contest was to see how much water you can drink and then hold your pee for how long, and then whoever was the longest would get the Wii. Well, one woman ended up drinking so much that her cells exploded and she died because you can overdose on water. And that is the story of Hold Your Wii for Wii.
Number one, the Sega Saturn. This one's bad. This one's really bad. And there's no way it couldn't be number one. Okay. So, the idea makes sense. Hey, we'll announce it and release the console at E3. It'll be genius. Everyone will want it and they'll get it instantly. The only problem was the execution. What ended up happening is that Sega didn't tell anyone about this move. Not the media, not developers, and not retailers. What happened was there was not nearly enough systems to meet up demand. By the time there were more machines, people stopped caring. Not only did that piss off customers, it pissed off third-party developers who didn't have time to make the launch library. Not a good idea. And then finally, what it led to is, well, the ultimate demise of the Saturn. And it's not just the Saturn that it hurt. It hurt the Dreamcast because there was no developers. People didn't trust Sega as it is. And then now, where are they? Making crappy Sonic games. What were they thinking?
That's it for another Top 10. Thanks for listening. Where can you find us?
Pretty sure you can find us on our homepage, outofhp.com. I think we have a Facebook. We have a Tumblr that we update. And what else?
We have a Twitter, twitter.com/outofhp. Pretty much anywhere you can find us, /outofhp. And we have just started finding the ways of Instagram, so find us there as well.
What about a Zanga? Do we have a Zanga? People still use those?
That shit's so old school.
You still use it? LiveJournal?
MySpace.
There we go.
MySpace.
Yeah.
We're musicians now.
Friendster.
That'd be awesome. I broke it. Yes. Let's make a Friendster.
I feel like you should keep that.
I am. Okay. And get.